Hello, everyone. Welcome to the English devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's begin in prayer. Heavenly Father, I come before your holy presence asking forgiveness of my sin so that my prayer can enter your throne. Lord, I glorify your holy name because you are good even here in the land of the living. We know that we are going to survive. We are going to get through our situations because we see your goodness here and now in the land of the living. Father, I ask that you will give us courage to press on, that you will give us the strength to take the next step. Father God, we are so weak and we are tired and we are exhausted and we are being attacked on every side. Shield us, Lord. Station your angels around us in battle array, ready to fight for us. Father, I thank you and I praise you because even though we are in battles of every kind, you have already had victory. You have already overcome. Father, help us to keep our perspective and to claim victory in your holy name. Father, I ask that you will be with those who are sick, who are struggling with a chronic or acute illness. Father, I ask that you will touch them and be their doctor, be their healer. And Lord, if that is not your will, I ask that you will help each person to understand what it is that you are trying to teach them, what it is that they need to learn or that they need to change, or comfort them if there is no particular lesson, if there is no particular reason. I ask that you will give them courage to face their illness, that you will give them strength, and that their faith will hold secure. These things I ask in your Son's name. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional is titled, Repent and Live. It was written by Yoandre Jimenez and translated by Nelson Berries. Our biblical base comes from Revelation chapter 3, verses 1 through 5. So says the word of God. And to the angel of the church of Sardis write, these things say, he who has the seven spirits of God and the seven stars, I know your works, that you have a name, that you are alive, but you are dead. Be watchful and strengthen the things which remain, that are ready to die, for I have not found your works perfect before God. Remember, therefore, how you have received and heard. Hold fast and repent. Therefore, if you will not watch, I will come upon you as a thief, and you will not know what hour I will come upon you. You have a few names, even in Sardis, who have not defiled their garments, and they shall walk with me in white, for they are worthy. He who overcomes shall be clothed in white garments, and I will not blot out his name from the book of life, but I will confess his name before my Father and before his angels. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. As old as existence itself, it is the concern of some for their image or personal appearance. Throughout history, the way that we dress, the image we project, has conveyed a consistent message of our position. Nobody dares to deny the importance of the appearance we show to the world. Slow talk, a melodious voice, and eloquent speech may offer you some credentials as an ambassador of men, but you cannot speak life if you are dead, nor transmit light unless you abide in it. It is often difficult to live with a costume or to be convincing after a while. Although there are actors who have managed to deceive for a long time, It is impossible to surpass the scrutiny of those who look at the heart. In Sardis, as in our times, there was a dead church among the living, and the words of the Lord reach our days as one of the greatest messages of love. I know your works. Be vigilant. Remember what you have received. No matter how long you have been dead, repent and live. It is useless to pretend that our image and actions testify of the Christ who lives in our hearts. Amen. My brothers and sisters, what a beautiful message from the Holy Spirit today. Even if you have walked in the Christian way for years and years and years and find yourself astray, you find yourself in darkness and lost, you have walked away from your faith, this is an invitation for you to repent and to live. My brothers and sisters, Jesus is waiting for you. Though you were dead, he will raise you up and give you life. It doesn't matter where you're coming from. It doesn't matter where you have been or how far you have gone. Jesus is waiting for you, arms opened wide, waiting for you. Even if you have not traveled away from the Christian walk, even if you have not walked away, but you are struggling in some area or another, Jesus is waiting for you. He is waiting for you to cast your cares and your burdens at his feet. Even if you have just done it yesterday, do it again today. He is our loving Savior. He is our Father. He is our friend. He is the one who wants to help and to carry those burdens for you. My brothers and sisters, no matter how long you have been dead or you have been cold and walked away from your faith, repent and live. Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory.
Down and I am free. your feet. I lay my life down for you, my King. You're all I want now, and my soul sings. Jesus, Jesus, at your feet, oh, to dwell and never leave. Jesus, Jesus, at your feet, there is no.
Amen. What a beautiful song. And now we invite you to check out the YouTube channel, SCC English Ministry, for the daily Bible reading as we continue with the book of Psalms. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children, now and forever. Amen.